Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this video is part of Esther's Ministries. Thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. And today I'm going to discuss a new wisdom builders from the Proverbs 24. But before I start, as always, this is the Word of God and with this truly a change is going to come if you read it. Okay, so I will dive right in into the material. Today I want to discuss Proverbs 24 from verse 30 till 34. And there's so much in these four scriptures. There's so much to learn about. And I've learned so much about it. Because as I say in every Wisdom Builder video, I need wisdom. And I think I'm not the only one. I think you too. So let's learn something today. Okay, verse 30. I walked by the field of a lazy person, the vineyard of one with no common sense. I saw that it was overgrown with nettles. It was covered with weeds, and its walls were broken down. Then, as I looked and thought about it, I learned this lesson. A little extra sleep, a little more slumber, a little folding of the hands to rest. Then poverty will pounce on you like a bandit. Scarcity will attack you like an armed robber. There's so much to learn about. Okay, first thing I want to talk about is what we can learn from this thing, from these scriptures, is that in life, when you start with something, don't just quit. Too many people start with things in their life, with their vision, with their business, with reading the word, and somewhere in the middle, they just stop. And what kind of reason? Number one reason in this scripture is because of laziness, because they are too much focus on to do the nice stuff, or to have fun stuff, or just to be happy. And it is so important for us to finish what we started. And because we can see from this scripture is that somebody has started a vineyard. So he was starting a vineyard. He even had walls, but these walls were broken down. And this person had also different kind of nettles in the vineyard. And this is so important, because if you do not prune what you do not need during your walking out in your vision, you will get an overflow of nettles. And also, you need common sense. So you need to know when you are doing stuff, you cannot do everything. And let me give you an example. For example, I made a commitment to study the word. I made a commitment to read the word. And sometimes my periods in life were just simple way dull moments. And sometimes I just didn't had any energy to go through the scriptures again and to read it once again, to speak it and to write it down, to memorize it, to study it, to dive into it. But I made a decision, I made a commitment, and too many people are stopping with this kind of commitment and because they are too much busy with their friendships, they're too much busy with their partying. they don't want to prune things they don't need in their life in order to get the things that they want in their life. And it is so important for us to evaluate our relationships all around us. The relationships around us, are they bringing us closer to Jesus Christ or just further? I needed to cut off a few people in my life in order for me to rededicate my life to the scriptures. And of course, I'm not calling everybody, hey, I don't want to see you anymore. It is a natural flowing ending because you make a decision. But you need to prune something because, as I said before, otherwise you will overgrown with nettles. You cannot do 10 things in one time and think that you will get there. You need to cut things loose from your life. And you need to evaluate what you need to cut off. So next is that the walls were broken down. So this person had built walls. And with walls also says boundaries in our life. If we do not have healthy boundaries in our life, the walls will cut down, the walls will fall down. So it is necessary. Sometimes I need to say, hey, I cannot talk to you right now because I am into the word, or I do not have time for this because I need to choose this, or for the vision. Sometimes I need to lay the things down to get other things be done. So it is a choice you make. Every time you make a choice and you evaluate, is this good? Does this bring me further in life, or slows me down or back me up? And of course you can have rest and you can have nice things, but please remember that your life just don't hang on to do nice things all the time. We need to have a balance in that. And this is verse 32. Then, as I looked and thought about it, I learned this lesson. And when I read that, I was starting visualizing this vineyard. I was visualizing how does this look like with so much thorns and wall was broken down. It is horrible. It's not nice. So eventually, 33, it says a little extra sleep, a little more slumber. And it is so important from, yes, we need rest, but also we need to work. We need to do stuff. And I've spoken to a lot of people and they will say, well, I don't like reading the word, it's boring, or I don't like to do this in order to get the vision done. And that's fine by me. But if you do not like it or you do not want it, that's okay. But eventually you will receive poverty, because if you do not work, and I'm not talking about working to receive the grace from the Lord, but also that is not what I'm talking about. We receive grace which we cannot work for. You can, even if you want to work for it, it is stupid. You will never receive grace for working. But when we want to start things in our life, we need to work for it. We need to work to a certain point in our life. So this is what I want to end with. So please do not be lazy. Please prune your, take an evaluation, sorry for my stuttering, take an evaluation in your life, which things you need to prune and which things you need to keep. And please finish what you've started. If you made a commitment to something, just go for it. Go do it. And don't think too much about other things. Just focus on your purpose. Focus on the things getting done in your life. And please do not be lazy at all. So that's the end of this video. But please do not forget to read the word, because with this, a change is gonna come. If you read it and if you do not quit during the period of time that you are start reading it and living it. Thank you so much for watching, and see you at the next Vision Builders. See you, bye. Thank you so much.